Children, let us continue the story. Quality, page number 25, the third paragraph, the last paragraph of the page. In the first two paragraphs, we are introduced about Gessler brothers who were running a shoemaking shop, and the narrator is describing about their quality of making the shoes in this story. And in the beginning of the lesson itself, he expressed his wonderful art of these brothers. And the protagonist of the story is the younger brother. These thoughts, of course, came to me later, though even when I was promoted to him at the age of perhaps 14, some inkling haunted me of the dignity of himself and brother. Here, the narrator says that he was having a big question of that pair of boots which were kept in the window was not changed, and wearing boots in the window made him to think why it's so. Then he came to know that later on, though he was promoted to him at the age of perhaps 14. From 14 years, that means in his age of 14, he is going to the shop. His father took him there and he was acquainted with them for years, and he had some kind of induction, that is, inkling means some kind of induction he had in his mind, wanted to know about something. So that something likely to happen, and intuition that something likely to happen, something he had an idea about, of the dignity of himself and brother. In his mind, it was keep coming that these two brothers are very dignified people. For to make boots, such boots as he made, seemed to me then, and still seems to me, mysterious and wonderful. So he had ever experienced such a good quality shoemaker. So it is really wonderful to him. I remember well my shy remark one day while stretching out to him my youthful foot. So here again the characteristics of the protagonist is mentioned by the narrator. He had the habit of taking the measurement of the foot of the person who gives order to make the shoes. So it is very simple act, and he draws the drawing of that foot, asks them to keep their foot on the piece of a paper or something and draw the outline of the foot. So once he was doing so, when the narrator went to give an order for a shoe, stretching out to him my youthful foot when he was very young, and he remembers some question he put before them. Isn't it awful hard to do, Mr. Gessler? So it is a really different act of doing, no? So he was asking that, and his answer, given with a sudden smile from out of the sardonic redness of his brow, it is an art. So here the accent, German accent is given, it is an art. Yes, it is an art. So he was in a sarcastic smile, he was saying that it is an art, it's nothing. So he took every act of making that shoe as an art. So in the beginning itself, I said that they were commitment towards their art of shoemaking. Both the brothers had that commitment towards the art of shoemaking. So he did each and every act of making that shoe as a art. So he never felt of that is it awfully hard? Is it never they thought to do each and every act as an art. Himself, he was a little as if made from leather, with his yellow crinkly face and crinkly reddish hair and beard, and neat folds slanting down his cheeks to the corners of his mouth, and his guttural and one-toned voice, for leather is a sardonic substance and stiff and slow of purpose. Here, the description of the protagonist. So here, how he looked. He himself looked like a little one made out of a leather, very yellow in color and crinkly. That means wrinkled face, face with all wrinkle on his face, and crinkly reddish hair. So his hair is also reddish in color. So it's typical German look. And beard and neat folds slanting down his cheeks to the corners of his mouth, and his voice, and it was a harsh sounding, harsh sound, and one tone voice, a monotonous single voice. For leather is a sardonic substance and stiff and slow of purpose. So they were described in such a way. And that was the character of his face, save that his eyes, which were grey-blue, had in them the simple gravity of one secretly possessed by the ideal. So here again, the description of the narrator described about the structure of the protagonist and the shoemaker. He had a blue, grey-blue eye, and his elder brother was so very like him. So they both of them looked alike. So they were looking, both of them had the same look. So like him, though a watery, paler in every way, with a great industry, that sometimes in early days I was not quite sure of him until the interview was over. Then I knew that it was he, if the words I will ask my brother had not been spoken, and that if they had, it was his elder brother. His elder brother was so very like him, and he also looked like him, only though watery, paler in every way, with a great industry. That sometimes in early days I was not quite sure of him until the interview was over. So until he had a talk with him, he didn't have a clear idea about these people. And they had always, together they did the work. That's what the character of both the brothers, the narrator, present here. When one grew old and wild and ran up bills, one somehow never ran them up with guestless brothers. It would not have seemed becoming to go in there and stretch out one's foot to that blue-eyed spectacled glance, weighing him for more than, say, two pairs, just the comfortable reassurance that one was still his client. When one grew old and wild and ran up bills, one somehow never ran them up with Gessler brothers. What he wants to say? No one will keep the money back for Gesslers. Whatever they order, surely they will pay it in time. Though they will be in shortage of money, but no one will stop paying them. That means they will not keep their money. As soon as they make the shoe, whenever it is produced and handed over to the customers, immediately they will pay them. It would not have seemed becoming to go in there and stretch out one's foot to that blue and spectacle glass, owing him for more than, say, two pairs. So whoever goes there surely will order for two. Just the comfortable reassurance that one was still his client. So he always goes there and always gave more number of shoes to be made. For it was not possible to go to him very often. His boots lasted terribly, having something beyond the temporary, some as it were essence of wood stitched into them. So again, the quality of the protagonist is mentioned here. Whatever the shoe he makes goes for long. It was not possible to go him very often. Why he was not possible for him to go very often? Because once you buy a shoe from him, it will last for long. It will last terribly long. And it will not get spoiled easily. That's what he wants to say. At present, you say that if you buy one pair of shoes or any sandals, how easily it gets spoiled. It will not go not for more than months, few months. But this shoemaker, whenever they make a shoe, they will make it solid. It will last terribly long. That means it will not get spoiled easily. So no one will go again and again to give order. One went in, not as into most shops, in the mood of, "Please serve me and let me go," but restfully, as one enters a church and sitting on the single wooden chair, waited for there was never anybody there. Listen again, the characteristics of the protagonist. First, he uses or he sells the shoes which made of good quality leather and of his own hand. He never displays anything which are bought. And whatever he makes will last terribly. That means it will not get spoiled easily. And again, the characteristics of the protagonist is mentioned here. Whoever wants to give order for a shoe will patiently wait there. One went in and asked into shops in the mood of, "Please serve me," not in a hurry. Whoever goes to his shop will take time and spend time, and they will not be in a hurry to do anything there, but restfully, so very quietly, and take time and ready to spend time in the shop. And it is compared here, the simile is given, as one enters a church. So once you enter into the church, it is the background of Christian writer, so he is giving that example. Once we go to the church, we will stay there till the sermon completes. So we will be there for hours. Once we go and sit on the chair, we will be there till the service gets over. So same manner, whoever goes to his shop will ready to spend time as if they are sitting in the church restfully, quietly, calmly. They'll sit there, and there one single wooden chair is kept. Only one wooden chair is kept, and they'll wait there for there. Was never anybody there. So when there is no one, still they will wait till they come. Soon over the top edge of the sort of well, rather dark and smelling soothingly of leather, which formed the shop, there would be seen his face or that of his elder brother peering down. So they'll be busy with some or other work until they come to that place where the wooden chair is kept. The customer will sit and wait there till any one of these two brothers come to ask about what they want. Quietly they sit, as if they sit in the church, and they will come. So in the room they are here, the narrator is depicting and visualizing the shop to us. As he has described in such a manner, one can visualize what kind of shop the Gessler brothers had. So smell of the rather dark and smelling soothingly of leather, all around the leather smell which formed the shop, there would be seen his face. You can see the face after few minutes or some time, or the protagonist or his elder brother peering down. They'll come there, a guttural sound and the tip top. Again the description, see, the staircase are made of wood, so tip top, brass slippers beating the narrow wooden stairs, and he would stand before one without coat, a little bent. So the description again, describing the protagonist here and the Gessler brothers. So without coat, simple, and the sympathetic condition of the shoemakers, a little bent. He had a posture of bending in leather apron. He wears a leather apron with sleeves turned back, blinking as if awakened from some dream of wood. So dull like that, or like an owl surprised in daylight and annoyed at this interruption. So they'll be busy in making and concentrating, putting their concentration only in their art. So if someone goes and calling them, they'll, as if they'll get up from sleep, or they are in like owl in the daylight, how it will blink. They'll blink and come and inquire about what they want. And I would say, how do you do, Mr. Gessler? Would you make me a pair of Russia leather boots? So many times the narrator met these Gessler brothers in their shop, and he is giving some of the incident which took place there in the shop. So when sometimes he goes to give order, so when they come, they will be like blinking like anything. So I used to ask like this, would you please make me a shoe made out of Russia leather? So here we will stop and we will continue the next class.